In 2021, there are a lot of changes to talk about when it comes to Google Photos, one of the best services available to back up, organize, and share your photos and videos with friends and family. Now, in this video, I'm going to take you through some of the biggest changes coming to Google Photos in 2021, as well as what's been added to the service within the past year. Last year, we did a video on how to use Google Photos, so if you're unfamiliar with Google Photos, I'd encourage you to pause this video and watch that one first, and then come back here for the changes. Now, by far, the biggest change coming to Google Photos will happen on June 1st. That's when the company will implement their new storage policy for Google accounts. Starting on June 1st, any new photo or video uploaded to Google Photos will count against the free 15 gigabytes of storage you get when you sign up for a Google account. This applies to both original quality photos, which currently count against storage, as well as high quality photos, which currently do not count towards your Google account storage limit. Also starting on June 1st, other Google products like Docs, Sheets, Slides, Drawings, and yes, even Jamboards will all start counting against your storage as well. So if you already have a Google Photos account, what exactly does this change mean for you? Well, first, any high-quality photos and videos that you've uploaded to Google Photos prior to June 1st, 2021 will not, I repeat, they will not count against that 15 gig storage limit. Only new photos and videos you upload to Google Photos after June 1st, 2021 will count against that 15 gig limit. Second, if you have a Google Pixel 1 through 5, any photos or videos you take and back up as high quality to Google Photos will continue to not count against your storage limit after June 1st, 2021. Now, what happens if you hit that 15 gigabyte limit for your Google account? Well, once you hit that limit, you will start having to pay for more storage. Google has created a personalized estimate you can use to determine how long your current storage may last by taking into account how frequently you back up photos, videos, and other content to your Google account. You can see your own personalized estimate by going to photos.google.com/storage. Now, before you go and upgrade your storage, there are ways to cut down on the existing storage you're using. Google will be releasing some new storage management tools after June 1st in Google Photos to help you cut down on your storage usage. The new tools can help you do things like identify screenshots, dark photos, blurry photos, etc., basically trying to help you get rid of any photos you may not want anymore. Google One, which we'll talk about in more detail in just a second, also has a management tool to help you delete files from your Google Drive and Gmail to help free up additional storage. So if you've cleaned up your storage as much as possible and you're still hitting that 15 gigabyte limit, it is time to upgrade your storage. So what are your storage upgrade options? To upgrade your storage, you'll need to subscribe to Google One, Google's membership program that gives you expanded storage, access to experts for Google product support, discounts in the Google Store, and more. Google One has several pricing tiers. The entry-level subscription is $20 a year or $199 a month for 100 gigabytes of storage. The next level is $30 a year or $299 per month for 200 gigabytes of storage plus 3% off at the Google Store. Next level is $100 a year for 2 terabytes of storage plus a 10% discount at the Google Store and access to Android VPN. The last storage tiers are probably for more heavy storage users and have the same discount and VPN access as the 2 terabyte plan. For $50 a month, you can get 10 terabytes of storage, or for $100 a month, you can get 20 terabytes of storage. If you're in a family, you can invite up to 5 additional family members to your plan to simplify your storage. Family members will get their own space to store personal files, emails, and photos, plus everyone will get access to additional Google One benefits like the Google Store discount and the VPN if you choose a plan that includes those. All right, well, that's everything for the storage changes coming to Google Photos this year. Now let's talk about some of the other things that Google has added to Google Photos since our video last year. One of the largest changes to Google Photos is the simplified UI and logo. In the app, there are now just 3 tabs: Photos, Search, and Library. The Photos tab shows you your photos with a memories carousel at the top. Search gives you quick access to the people, places, and things most important to you. There's also an interactive map now, which shows you a heat map of the areas around the globe that you've taken photos of. The hotter the colors, the more photos you've taken there. It's pretty neat. The Library tab contains the most important destinations in your photo library, like albums, trash, favorites, and more. Another thing that was added is new sharing controls in albums. When you share an album, the default option is to share with a specific person via their Google account, giving you more control over who's added to the album. You do still have the option to share albums in Google Photos via a link and can turn on or off link sharing at any time. You can also remove someone from an album, which will remove the photos and videos they added to it. Another area of Google Photos that Google improved are the options you have when editing photos. Google Photos now has more easy suggestions to enhance your photos, making them warm, cool, or even suggesting a color pop or making a photo black and white. When you use the suggested enhancement, the settings that were adjusted will turn blue, and you can go to adjustments and see them and further refine the edits. Portrait lighting is another recent editing addition to Google Photos for phones like the Pixel 4a and the Pixel 5. Portrait lighting gives you more control over how your portraits look, and you can add portrait lighting to regular photos that weren't captured in portrait mode. Look for this mode to come to other Pixels in the future as well. The last new couple of things coming to Google Photos involves the Memories feature. Google Photos will now automatically create cinematic photos for you. Just make sure to update your app, and when one is ready, it'll show up in your recent highlights at the top of your photo grid. You can even send it as a video to friends and family as well. There's also a new collage feature to see memories in a new way, like a then and now view, which you can see just how much someone has grown. Perfect for viewing photos of your kids or pets. Also, memories of your favorite people, things like places and activities such as baking or hiking, will be rolling into your memories feed soon as well. Well, I hope you found this video helpful and informative, and if you did and liked it, make sure you hit that thumbs up button below and subscribe to the channel to see more Google product videos like this one, as well as other videos on other tech products. Well, that's gonna do it for me. For 6 months later, I'm Josh Tedder. Thanks for watching.